What's up guys, my name is Abhinav and welcome back to another video on this channel. And today we are going to do something special. It is Diwali time, it is festive time, and so we are going to celebrate Diwali in our way. And that is by making some fireworks on the chessboard, that's right. And today I have a very interesting a gambit which I have found recently in a Leeches article. So I was going through Leeches and I was trying to discover new things on the website, and I found this article written by Naidish Arkasha. So this is an article about Carlsen using the Halloween gambit when he was a small child. Now he is a world champion and a very well renowned player. So Halloween gambit, I had little background knowledge. I had tried it sometimes
and I had decent results with the Halloween gambit.
So I was quite intrigued actually and very excited to look at this game. So I'm not doing much here, I'm just going to show you. I found this game and I'll show you and I'll try to explain it in my words what is happening in the board. Credit where credit is due. Thank you so much to Naidish Arkasha here. You can check out the Leeches ID if you want to play against that person. We'll also leave a like here, 24, very nice. Carlsen is a genius, yes he is, and he was a prodigy in his childhood. Let's watch his blitz game here, where he crushed an international master with the Halloween gambit. We'll have a look at the opening right now. And also, if you're new here, do consider smashing the like button, also subscribing. It will help a lot. Thank you very much. And I'll be very happy and it will make my Diwali even better. Let us jump right into it, guys. E4, E5. Alright, so this is the way the opening starts. We are white. Knight f3, knight c6. And now, generally what we do is, we move our bishop to c4. Rather, what we are going to do here is going to play the knight to c3 to provoke black into playing the four knights variation. And now we'll just make a silly move so that black thinks that okay, we don't know how to play chess, and black plays the move g6. And if black plays the move g6 in the e4 main line basically, so g6, we will play the move knight into e5, sacrificing a piece right away, taking a pawn. Black takes knight into e5, play the pawn to d4. Now the center is completely in our control and knight has to retreat back. Knight to c6, d5, knight again has to go back. If the knight comes to e5, then the pawn will push to f4 and again the knight will be trapped. Knight b8, now again controlling the center, e5 push. As you can see, a lot of fireworks going on in the center of the board. Knight to g8, now white is totally developed and black has just one pawn on g6, doing nothing much. So we'll play the move d6, trying to cut off the f8 bishop. C takes d6, e takes d6, and now some counterplay for black. Black is an international master. White is obviously Carlsen. We are having a look at Carlsen's game. Queen to f6. And now queen to f6, the idea is simple, trying to attack the d6 pawn with the bishop and with the queen. Knight to b5, supporting the pawn on d6, and also knight to c7, and cheeky little check to nab a rook on a8. Knight to a6, trying to support the c7 square. Bishop c4, normal development. Bishop h6, okay, interesting move from black's camp. Queen e2 check, and now you can see the knight cannot come in between to protect the king, so the king has to move king to f8. Bishop to e3, although white can take bishop into h6, but then black will get some development, so we'll just play bishop to e3. Bishop takes, now f takes e3. The idea of bishop e3 was to provoke black into capturing the bishop, so that after the move f into e3, the f file is completely open for the rook. Queen h4 check, g3, queen h5,
queen f2. This is just roaming around for a couple of moves. This continued for a couple of moves,
and then knight came to h6. Now rook f1, the idea was made very clear on the 14th move itself, that the f file should be opened. And obviously rooks belong on open files.
Smash like for more chess tips, guys.
Very nice. So we are at move number 17, knight h6.
Sorry, move number 20, not 17.
Rook f1, queen h5, queen f2, queen f5, queen e2, queen e5. This time black didn't decide to play queen to h5, rather played queen to e5. Castle, long castling, because we are definitely going for the king. No matter what, we are totally attacking in this position. We, in the sense, yeah, Carlsen is attacking, so we are just having a look at the game. from a beginner's or an intermediate's point of view. Rook to d5, the idea is simple again, attacking the queen and developing queen to e8. As you can see now, I cannot
highlight here, I don't know why, but
white is having a lot of development and black's pieces are just miserable. Terrible position for black, I don't know how he is going to manage. Queen to d2, just trying to coordinate the pieces for now. Queen d4 check, yes. King g8 could have been played, f6 I think is a mistake. But g4, g5, yes, attacking the f6 pawn. Knight f5, although I think here that white can sacrifice rook into f5. Carlsen didn't decide to do so, so we are not going to have a look into it a lot. I would rather personally commit a sacrifice just for the sake of it, because it is Diwali time, need a lot of fireworks. G cross f6, rook cross f6, and now Carlsen, listen to me. See, I went in the past and told him, Carlsen, you have to sacrifice the rook on f5. So rook cross f5, g cross f5, rook g1 check. And now if the king moves f8, king cannot come to f7 because the bishop is eyeing. King has to go to f8 and then the rook will be hanging. That is why queen to g6, and now we are a queen up. Now it should be very easy to win after this. And Carlsen just annihilated this international master. And after this move, queen to g3 check, the d6 knight is hanging and the opponent resigned. So this was the game which Carlsen played, and I have explained it in my simple words. I hope you enjoyed and you learned something, and I will sincerely encourage you guys to try out the Halloween Gambit this Diwali and check out your results and tell me, did you win or did you lose by playing the Halloween Gambit? I hope you win. Do tell me in the comment section. And again, this is myself, Abhinav Bhatt, signing off, and thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care and bye.